guys, I'm road testing the Puma Velocity Nitro. See my thoughts after this. Cue the music. Hey everyone, so today I'm gonna do a review on the Velocity Nitro by Puma. If you haven't noticed, Puma has been really kicking in the door in the distance running shoe market. They came out with the Nitro series, which includes the Eternal Nitro, which is a stability shoe, the Liberate Nitro, which is a speed shoe, Velocity Nitro, more of a natural utility shoe, and then they came out with the Deviate Nitro. Deviate Nitro is their top. This is really for the super long runs and maybe even possibly a race shoe. Comes with, has a carbon plate built in. The Velocity Nitro does not. And then you have, with this, you also have Deviate Nitro Elite, which is basically their race shoe. It's gonna compete with, you know, Nike, Brooks, and ASIC, and everyone else. All right, so there's a lot to love about this shoe. The Velocity Nitro has a very breathable upper. Combined with the, has a very nice tongue with the heel, really gives you that kind of inner boot feel. Shoe actually, the way it rides, the way it feels, reminds me of one of my favorite shoes, the Nike Lunar Eclipse. When you add the lace lock with the whole configuration, I mean, your heel is just locked in there. It's not moving around, which is exactly what I want to feel when I'm on the road. I don't want to be, you know, feeling like I'm sliding around in my shoe. So really sleek design, it's very comfortable. Okay, so the midsole is made from a nitro infused foam. That's why you get the name Nitro for the whole series. One thing I really like is this lip right here, this hard plastic. You'll see these on a lot more shoes. The Nike React series has this, the big lip on the back. The Brooks Hyperon Tempos also have the lip. That's really about, when you get the heel strike, it's about helping to keep the pronation in check, because this is a natural shoe. So that's really what that's about, because you have this part land and it helps stabilize on landing. So really like the feel. It really grips the road, very responsive. The outer sole has this thing called Puma grip, which is, it actually reminds me sort of a Nike Pegasus. Just the way it's very thin, but very grippy. So I've had these for about 4 months. I haven't had a chance to try them on a wet road, wet sidewalk, or anything. But I assume if you're in an area that has icy sidewalks and stuff, something like this is going to come in super handy. I live in Southern California, so I don't really have icy sidewalks and things like that to deal with. Overall aesthetic, very good looking shoe. One critique I would say is that like this shoe and the Deviant look very, very similar, and they tended to have this be the main color that they're going to promote. So I would say, you know, if you're going to have a series like this, maybe, you know, each line has a main color that you focus on, you know. So the Deviant maybe is the orange, and this one, you know, maybe comes in black as the main color, and then, you know, so on, to help alleviate some confusion with users. So these performed exceptionally well for me. You know, this is a shoe that really wants to go fast. You know, between the tongue and the heel, you really get that boot feel that I like. It's very unusual to find that in a running shoe. The shoe feels light, but durable. The midsole was noticeably responsive when it hit the road. Very similar to the Brooks Hyperon Tempo with the DNA Flash midsole. The Puma grip, outsole tracks the road well, and combined with the responsiveness of the midsole, really makes this a great daily trainer. Puma is really coming in strong with their new Nitro series. I love that Puma created an entire line for the different types of training runs in a typical program. The Velocity is your neutral running shoe for regular, easy to mid-range runs. Deviant Nitro is for long runs, while the Liberate Nitro is for speed runs. If you are a runner that pronates and you prefer a stability shoe, they have the Eternity Nitro, which has a large heel lip to help stabilize. And then obviously, I already talked about the Deviant Nitro, which has the carbon plate in, which is super hot right now. If you're looking for a really solid mid-range priced shoe, look at the Velocity Nitro. All right, if you're interested in picking up a pair of the Velocity Nitros, the link is in the bio. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. And if you like this video and this is your first time, please hit follow, like, or subscribe, and I will be sure to make more. All right, till next time, run positive.